broomstick was my first pencil, and the sand was my paper.
Greetings, all you very rare individuals. Welcome to another Afro-Scot podcast. This is episode 16, and we're going to talk about why Africa is great. Specifically, we're going to focus on the artist this time of Africa. And I wanted to focus on the sculptor, the painter, and one of the most influential artists of the 20th century, Ben Enwonwu. Now, who is Ben Enwonwu? Well, he's not known much, but for seasoned artists, you know that he created a sculpture for Queen Elizabeth II. She sat for him in Buckingham Palace, and this was very rare at the time because not many Africans have been commissioned to do such a thing. And that's just a testament to his skill, his fame, and his respect, prestige. And he took a lot of his inspiration from Nigerian history, tribal dances, and Nigerian culture, African culture. And he even created sculptures for the United Nations as well, which is sitting at the front of United Nations building in New York, which is another way of saying that Nigeria is now wanting to be a part of that peace. And he used the sun deity to show that. And there's one in Lagos as well, as shown here. But the reason why I chose Ben Enwonwu was because of how he doesn't stray away from his roots. You know, he took a lot of his inspiration from the metal sculptures of Ife, which was actually so ahead of his time before the Italian Renaissance, and they were so technically brilliant. You know, and a lot of people don't know this about Africa, about how great we are. You know, we hear about the poverty and the bad parts, but we never hear about how great our artwork is or how during the 1800s a lot of our artwork was stolen by the Europeans and put in the museums. And even some of the artwork was put in an exhibition that Picasso visited, which then became Cubism in the future. So that type of history isn't really talked about in Africa. You know, it's always the struggle that's talked about, but it's never the great parts. You know, Africa is such a great continent, and it's filled with some great artists as well, like Ben Enwonwu. And if you look at a lot of his sculptures and what he designs, you can see that they have a strong resemblance to sort of the sculptures you would see shown through African history. And he took a lot of inspiration from African dancers too. For example, the masquerades who would dance in the villages with the spiritual dances that they would do, or even women themselves who would dance as they move their bodies, and he would show the movement through his quick brush strokes. And his sculptures as well seem to focus on the female form, you know, stretching it, or even making it slender and slim just to show the elegance of it. And I like that because it shows how Africa really values the technical part. And Ben Enwonwu wasn't afraid to leave what was going on at the time with the modernist movement in Europe. You know, he stuck to his roots and he mixed both to create a completely new style, which actually influenced a lot of artists today. But this is very strange. Even though he influenced so many of the artists, he's not even talked about that much or even mentioned much when it comes to art. You know, and a lot of his contemporaries at the time who didn't really succeed as much as him are making more money now, or are even more recognized than Ben Enwonwu, which to me is very strange, because he was the only African artist at the time to get Queen Elizabeth II to sit for him. And he was even at the time a member of the Royal Anthropological Institute London, and also a member of the Royal Academy of Arts London, and many, many more. He was very successful. His influence was widespread, and though there's many American artists like Jacob Lawrence and Ernie Barnes, which is just to name a few, there's not that many African artists that reached the point that he did in the 20th century. And due to not a lot of people knowing about it, I thought it would be great to show his greatness, his African greatness, through this podcast, and to remind everybody that you being an African is a great thing. Don't let anybody tell you any different. And by understanding that we are great artists in a great history, this will lead you to having a strong Afro-Scot identity.